Do you want to build a time series forecasting model that incorporates additional predictors and holidays? In this tutorial, we will talk about how to achieve this using Facebook Profit in Python. After the tutorial, you will learn how to include seasonalities in time series prediction, how to add standard holidays of a country, how to add special events such as Super Bowl, how to add additional predictors, how the time series model performance is impacted by these hyperparameters. Let's get started. In the first step, we will install and import libraries. iFinance is the Python package for pulling stock data from Yahoo Finance. Profit is the package for the time series model. After installing iFinance and Profit, we will import them into the notebook. We will also import Pandas and NumPy for data processing, Seaborn and Matplotlib for visualization, and mean absolute error and mean absolute percentage error for the model performance evaluation. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. The second step pulls stock data from Yahoo Finance API. We will pull 2 years of daily data from the beginning of 2020 to the end of 2021. Start date equals 2020-0102 because January 1st is a holiday. And there is no stock data on holidays and weekends. End date equals 2022-0101 because iFinance excludes the end date. So we need to add 1 day to the last day of the data end date. Train end date equals 2021-12-15 means that the splitting date for the training and testing dataset is December 15th of 2021. We will download the closing prices for two tickers, GOOG and VTI. GOOG is the ticker for Google, and VTI is the ticker for the Vanguard Total Stock Market Index Fund ETF. The goal of the time series model is to predict the closing price of Google stock. The closing price of VTI will be used as an additional predictor. The downloaded dataset is in the Pandas data frame format. We can see that the output has two level column names. Using drop level, the first level column name close is dropped. Using dot info, we can see that the dataset has 505 records and there are no missing values. Next, let's visualize the closing prices of the two tickers using Seaborn and add the legend to the plot using Matplotlib. We can see that the price for Google increased a lot starting in late 2020 and almost doubled in late 2021. Step 3 transforms the dataset into a time series modeling dataset. Profit requires at least two columns as inputs, a DS column and a Y column. The DS column has the time information. Currently, we have the date as the index, so we reset the index and rename the date to DS. The Y column has the time series values. In this example, because we are predicting the Google closing price, the column name GOOG is changed to Y. There is no predefined name for the additional predictor in Profit, so we can keep the name VTI as is. Next, let's check the correlation between the Google stock closing price and the VTI closing price. The value of 0.967 is close to 1, indicating that there is a high correlation between the two closing prices. Therefore, VTI closing price is a potential good predictor for the Google closing price. In step 4, we will do the train test split. For time series data, usually a threshold date is chosen, then we set the dates before the threshold to be the training dataset and the dates after the threshold to be the testing dataset. Based on the threshold date we set before, there are 494 data points in the training dataset and 11 data points in the testing dataset. Checking the minimum and maximum values for the train and test dataset separately gave us the starting and ending dates. The training dataset has the dates from January 2, 2020 to December 15, 2021. And the testing dataset has the dates from December 16, 2021 to December 31, 2021. In step 5, We will build a univariate baseline model using the default profit hyperparameters and fit the model using the training dataset. Profit automatically fits daily, weekly, and yearly seasonalities if the time series is more than 2 cycles long. The model information shows that the yearly seasonality and the daily seasonality are disabled. The daily seasonality is disabled because we do not have sub-daily time series. The yearly seasonality is disabled although we have 2 years of data because there are no stock price data on holidays and weekends, so we have less than 365 data points for each year. We will continue with the default values for the baseline model and force the yearly seasonality in the next model to see the impact of the yearly seasonality. To make a forecast, we first need to create a future data frame. Periods equals 16 means that we would like to make predictions for the next 16 days. If you remember that the testing dataset has 11 data points, you might wonder why we put 16 instead of 11 as the number of periods here. That is because there are 5 weekends and holidays from December 16th to December 31st in 2021. We need to add those days back in order to get the predictions till December 31st of 2021. After making the prediction on the future data frame, we can plot the result using dot plot. The black dots are the actual values. The blue line is the prediction. The blue shades are the uncertainty interval. The default value for the uncertainty interval is 80%. So we are using 80% here. The uncertainty interval is calculated based on the assumption that the average frequency and magnitude of trend changes in the future will be the same as the historical data. The historical data trend changes are projected forward to get the uncertainty intervals. In addition to the forecast plot, profit also provides the components plot. From the component plot chart, we can see that the Google stock closing price has an overall upward trend. The weekly seasonality shows that the price tends to be lower at the beginning of the week and higher at the end of the week. Next, let's check the model performance. The forecast data frame does not include the actual values, so we need to merge the forecast data frame with the test data frame to compare the actual values with the predicted values. The mean absolute error for the baseline model is $84, meaning that on average, the forecast is off by $84. Given the Google price of nearly $3,000, the prediction is not bad. The mean absolute percent error for the baseline model is 2.9%, meaning that on average, the forecast is off by 2.9% of the stock price. The baseline model already gives us good estimations. Can we tune the model to make the estimations better? In step 6, we will force the model to consider the yearly seasonality. When initiating the profit model, the yearly seasonality and weekly seasonality are explicitly set to true, and then fit on the training data. The forecast plot is much better than the baseline model. The predictions are more aligned with the actual values, and the uncertainty interval is much narrower. For the components plot, besides trend and weekly seasonality, there is a yearly seasonality chart showing the seasonality over the year. The model performance is better than the baseline model. Mean absolute error decreased to $60 from the baseline model's $84. Mean absolute percent error decreased to 2% from the baseline model's 2.9%. In step 7, we added the VTI price as an additional predictor using the add regressor function. Standardize equals false means the regressor will not be standardized. VTI is chosen as a convenient example of illustrating the process of building a multivariate model. In practice, multiple features need to be created and evaluated as feature engineering and feature selection steps for the model. When making forecasts for the multivariate model, we need to make sure that the regressors have values for the forecast periods, so we used inner join and appended VTI data to the future data frame. In the case that the forecast is for the future without the regressor data, separate models need to be built for the regressors to get the predictions for the future dates. If there are missing values, we can use .fill to fill the missing values with the previous day's data. Compared with the model with no additional regressor, we can see that the model with a regressor has the predictions more aligned with the actual values. The components plot has one additional chart for the additional regressor. The multivariate model performance is much better than the univariate model. Me decreased to $31 from the univariate seasonality model's $60. MAPE decreased to 1% from the univariate seasonality model's 2%. Besides seasonalities and additional predictors, we can also incorporate holidays and special events in a profit time series model. In step 8, we will add special events and U.S. holidays to the multivariate model and see how it impacts the model predictions. Firstly, let's create two special events, COVID start and Super Bowl. For the COVID start event, we set the date to be March 15th of 2020. Then extend the event to 15 days before and 15 days after using lower window and upper window separately. For the Super Bowl event, we set the date in 2020 and 2021 separately, and extend the event to 7 days before and 1 day after. Then the two events are concatenated together to one data frame called events. When initiating the profit model, the data frame name events is passed to the hyperparameter holidays. Profit has built-in country-specific holidays. We add U.S. holidays to the model using add country holidays and setting country name equals U.S. Using train holiday names, we can see the list of holidays and events used for the modeling fitting. When doing a forecast, the holiday and special events effects are included. The components plot has one additional plot for the holidays including special events. The added holiday effects did not improve the performance of the multivariate model. The increase to $48 from the multivariate model's $31. MAP increased to 1.6% from the multivariate model's 1%. This shows that the holidays and two special events added are not good predictors for Google's stock price changes. On the contrary, it introduced noise to the model and decreased the model performance. However, for some dataset types such as retail sales prediction, having holidays and special events can be very helpful. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about time series forecasting, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.